CNNPhilippines.com. Who show the brightest at the Oscars red carpet to break down the hits and the misses? We have here the studio fashion blogger, Kat Arambulo. Good morning, Kat.
Good morning.
Thank you for waking up early. Okay, we're going to ask you a couple of things about yesterday's Oscars. What is the most common fashion trend that you noticed while seeing?
People wearing gold, neutrals, nude, red, and black.
Ooh.
If you notice, they were kind of safe this year.
I was going to say, compared to, like, you have the music awards, they're kind of brighter and more all out there, right? Okay, you gave us a list of your best dressed at the red carpet, so we're going to ask you all of them of why you think they're best dressed. Let's start with Jessica Biel.
Wasn't she beautiful? I just have to say, Jessica Biel was gorgeous. She was wearing a dress by Kaufman Franco and jewels by Tiffany. I think that she pulled this off, the stunningly beautiful dress, perfectly.
Understated elegance.
Of course.
Emma Stone. Let's go ahead and show the so Kat can see a picture of Emma Stone. Okay, there she goes.
Emma Stone. Doesn't she look like she really came there to win the Oscars?
This is glamour.
I mean, this is 1920s vintage Givenchy.
Down to the hair.
She really looked like she was going to take home the Oscar, and I think it was perfect.
Okay, next up, you think Hailee Steinfeld looked really good.
I think she looked amazing. I mean, the applique on her dress was fantastic. She had this ethereal sweetness and edgy look to her look.
Yes, and me, I think her makeup was just like impeccable.
Exactly. It went with the whole total outfit.
Nice. Okay, Brie Larson is up next. Let's take a look at how. Okay. Why did you like this?
I love it. I love the structure in her dress. She's wearing Oscar de la Renta. And I feel that the structure with her dress as well as the ruffles gave it a little bit more glamour to it.
Okay, and Nicole Kidman.
Nicole Kidman, I'm actually torn between her being on the best and worst, only because I feel that the dress kind of washed her away.
Yeah, she looks too white.
She looks too white, exactly. So it was kind of in between.
I love the dress.
And I love Nicole Kidman separately, but she's had better looks.
Okay, well, of course, if you have the best, you have the worst. Let's go and talk about the worst dress and why.
Yes.
Scarlett Johansson. It's one of the worst for you.
Yes.
Okay, why?
I mean, it's loose everywhere. Like, I feel this is a casual dress, which is not really
Oscar-worthy.
Oscar-worthy.
Yeah. But what about the hair? Do you like this look on her?
It looks more rock and roll for me.
I
think she pulled this off in the Grammys. Versus being an Oscar.
Okay, next. Janelle Monáe. Is that how you say it? Okay, Janelle Monáe. Let's go ahead.
Okay, I just have to say, doesn't she look like a cake topper? It's too much. I feel that it's like this medieval look that she's trying to pull, which just doesn't work.
Yeah, I agree.
She lost the glam.
More Game of Thrones, maybe.
More Game of Thrones, exactly.
Okay, Amelia Warner is up next.
Amelia Warner, I feel like it was just so heavy.
Yeah.
You know, the elegance, you know, she was like blown away there. I mean, you can't really see much of her body.
She looks like she's getting married.
She looks like she's getting married. Right? And this could be another Game of Thrones outfit.
Exactly. Okay. Halle Berry.
You know, I actually loved her hair for this. I think it made a statement, but I feel that it was a little bit too much with the dress. Mm-hmm. There was so much going on with the top as well as her hair. So maybe if her dress was a little bit more plain, then the hair would have worked.
Yeah.
But together, it just... Yeah,
more music awards than Hollywood. I agree. Okay, next is Chrissy Teigen.
Again, bust heavy. You know, I think she has to tone it down a bit, especially in the bust area because it's quite exposed and big, so it kind of makes it
too much. It stole the show.
Yes.
Okay, Ruth Negga.
Okay, I love this dress. But not for the Oscars. I feel that it is a dress for Halloween, maybe. I mean, it's a bit gothic, right? Look at the total look, even the way her demeanor was, you know, she wasn't really smiling, you know, the way her makeup was done. It's a bit vampire-y / Beetlejuice, like, it's a perfect Halloween look.
True.
It's Valentino.
Oh, okay.
It's Valentino.
Kristen Dunst. Okay, let's see her outfit here.
Okay, this one was in between also. I just didn't like the way her bust was so structured, pointing toward the high heavens, right?
Oh.
Like, Lotus down the sides, like you can see her bust pointing up.
Yeah.
So the structure may have been a little bit too much, but I mean, she has an hourglass figure and she's beautiful, so.
Okay, and last is Meryl Streep, who everyone thought might win, but didn't end up winning. Let's see her gown.
You know, the gown would have been good, but I just don't feel it was age appropriate.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel that it didn't flatter her body as much.
Mm-hmm.
She had, she's had a lot of other better outfits.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel that she could have done better for this gown.
Okay, for something as big as this, how do you think that they should get ready? Like, how do you prepare for such a big...
Oh, this takes a lot of preparation, I can imagine. I mean, they get stuff in these runway shows as well, right?
Uh-huh.
But I feel that the most important thing is they have to know their body. They have to get a good stylist. They have to get a dress that complements their skin tone, especially.
Mm-hmm.
They don't want to be washed out with their outfits.
Right.
So I think this is months in preparation.
And
maybe just a little styling.
Just to relate to the Philippines, do we go this big when we have award shows here?
So.
Do we?
I think so. I think a lot of people make an effort now. I mean, this is the time that designers can showcase their work.
Yeah.
And of course, showcasing their work on celebrities, translates to sales. It's one whole big package, right?
Right. Well, Kat, you're always on point. That's why you're the one you always work on. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here in the program. Again, we've just spoken with fashion blogger Kat Arambulo. All right. New day. We'll be right back. We have a lot more stories for you. Stay tuned. To the death penalty bill. This after the House majority limits the crimes punishable by death to only drug-related offenses. Lawmakers will vote on the bill on second reading Wednesday to allow them time to polish the final version. The Senate will tackle the government's proposed tax reforms. The Ways and Means Committee will heed the hearing.